Hari Om friends. Today we're going to discuss the significance of this epic festival, Ram Navami. Ram Navami is celebrated for the birth of Lord Rama. Rama is the central character in the epic Ramayana. Lord Rama is the son of King Dasharatha. Rama means charming, delightful, pleasant, pleasing, also referenced as dark colored. Sage Valmiki in his Ramayana portrayed Lord Rama as a symbol of perfection. He is perfect in all aspects of life. We all have many roles in our life, and most people seem to play one role to some extent well, but the great sage Valmiki portrayed Lord Rama as a symbol of perfection who played all roles of his life to its best. You cannot find another person who can play each role to its pinnacle, to its perfection. Valmiki portrayed Rama as an ideal son, a noble leader, a right husband, a wonderful friend, a noted enemy, and a great brother. You name a role, Rama played it to perfection. So many critics couldn't understand how can one person play each role or all role to perfection. So today we thought we are celebrating Ram Navami. Let us try and rise above our misunderstandings. There are some people who take few aspects and then say, how is it possible? One aspect I'm going to take up today is Rama's dealing with Vali. Vali and Sugriva were brothers and they were the leaders of the monkey kingdom. Sugriva was the noble and the virtuous brother, and Vali was the vicious and unscrupulous person. So they both were leaders, but Vali, being unscrupulous and vicious, used the wrong ways, toppled the noble Sugriva and became the leader. And Sugriva approaches his good friend Lord Rama for help and support. Rama in this aspect plays the role of a wonderful friend, the most beneficial friend you can have. Rama devises a plan. He requests Sugriva to invite Vali for a single combat. And Vali had this unique power through his tapas that anyone he meets in battle, he derives 50% of their strength. He derives to himself. So, and Sugriva was not as powerful as Vali, and he knew that he would lose the battle. But Rama promises him, he said, look here, you will win the battle, trust me. And Sugriva enters a battle with Vali. And the story goes, Lord Rama hits behind the tree and in an appropriate time, releases an arrow and shoots Vali and eliminates Vali and reinstates Sugriva as a leader. This has gathered a lot of critics. There's a philosophical significance to it. Vali represents lust, the negative tendencies in an individual. The Sugriva represents the positive tendencies. The mind, when it's powerful, falls a prey to lust. And when the mind is powerful and the lust is strong, they become a victim of the world. The senses take over. You become a helpless victim of the sense objects of the world. So Lord Rama hiding behind a tree represents a seeker who withdraws himself or herself from the sense objects, works on themselves. They are with themselves where they fortify their intellect. They raise their spiritual knowledge, and then when they meet the world, when they meet the sense objects, they seem to have a victory over the sense objects. That is the significance of Lord Rama hiding behind and then shooting Vali is just a representation of our good qualities, our virtuous qualities gaining precedence and winning over the negative qualities. You'll also observe Lord Rama carries a bow and arrow all the time. It symbolizes that if you are a spiritually aligned seeker, you are working on yourself on a consistent basis, you will be ready to face any challenge in life. You will have all emotions, but you will not become emotional. You will work with the purest of thought process and you will align yourself to a higher ideals in life. So Lord Rama having the bow and arrow is a symbolic representation of, look here, whatever the challenges are, I will face it and I will win this battle. Friends, on this day of Ram Navami, let us take this pledge that we will work on ourselves. We will raise ourselves in such a way, whatever the challenges are, we are ready to face them and we will be victorious. Best wishes to one and all.